Now start with the second experiment, that is deep flip flop. So to create, now to start, before start with deep flip flop programming, first you close the existing program which is showing that windows, wave window, then simulation window object. You know. To close this one, go to file and click on close. Again, keep on closing all the files, all the windows, when till the disclose when disclose tab get disappeared. It get disappear. Okay, now it's close all the tab windows. I have closed it. Now only showing two windows, that is project window, library window, and transcript window. Okay, now to start with again deep flip flop. Again go to file, click on new, and choose project. It will ask for the operation will close the current project. Are you want to continue? Yes, click on yes. So it will appear the pop up the window with the create project. Now you can give the project name as, I will give the DFF. Okay, I'll project location I'll keep the same thing, and work library I'll not change it. I'll click OK. Again it'll ask for the your source file creation. To create the source file creation, click on create new file, and will ask for the give the file name. So you can give the file name as deep flip flop with the pauses, and write pause because it is VM requirement is we should trigger with the positive edge of the clock signal. Then choose the add file type to Verilog, change to VHDL to Verilog, click OK. Then again click OK on the again close this the previous add item to the project window, close this one. After closing, now you come back to the project window or palette, will appear your file name dff.pause.v. Still the status is question mark, then type of file is Verilog, the order and modifier are nothing but the created date and time. Now you need to add your source code into that. So right click on this file and click on edit. So right now I'll do the copy and paste instead of typing all the files. Again same thing, the keywords appear in the red color, the sky blue color is module name, the variable name is in violet color, then the at the rate symbols are appears in the blue color. Okay. I'll click on now next work, after adding your code part, next work is need to compile it. To compile, again come back to project and right click on the your source file and choose compile and click on compile selected. So in the transcript window will appear the message that compile of dpause.v was successful. Nothing but there is no errors in the your source program. Okay. If any error occurs, for example, I'll remove this one, the arrow mark. Again, I'll recompile it. Again, it's saying that successful because as I'm using assignment statements, that's why I'm putting the arrow mark. So, what I have to do? Okay, instead of you can, it will not appear here also.
Okay. Sir, output a code
button. No, to do output. Okay, I know. I'll let the error message to you people. I'll save this one. Again, I'll compile it one. Again, it shows the message that dpause.v was successful. Now, next work is to simulate this one. So, again, go to library. Again, same thing. Find out the work library. In that, you find the module name. The previous module name is MUX821. Now, is changed to DFF. DFF is this is module name. In their source program, again right click on this DFF to simulate, click on simulate, it will again appear two windows now get appear, that is simulation and object window. Now you need to, there is no waveform window. To get waveform window, come back to this simulation window, sim window, and right click on your module name DFF and add, click, go to add, go to wave, then click on all item in region. So it will appear the waveform window. In the waveform window, we can check that your inputs are D, clock, and Q bar are both are output. Now the next work, you have to give the inputs to D and clock. So again, same process you have to follow it. Right click on D, click on force, and only change the value and change this to 1. Then click OK. Then clock, right click on it. Now here, instead of clicking on force value, I have to click on the clock signal. So click on clock, that is define clock. So no need to change any offset, duty cycle, period or logic values. Keep as it is. Even the edge of it, whether you want rising edge or falling edge, keep it rising edge. Now click OK on it. So I given the input D as 1 and I have given the clock signal. Now next work is to run this one. Again go to simulation, go to run and click on run 100. So it will appear the both clock signal, and I'll zoom this one. To zoom, you can choose the zoom option. Now you can check that during positive edge of the clock signal, the Q is 1 and Q bar is 0. But during negative edge, nothing but falling edge, there is no change in Q and Q bar. Q is 1 also and Q bar is 1. Nothing but during, it should, output should change only during positive edge. Negative edge, there is no change. Okay. So this must be the output of this D flip-flop. Okay. Now next we'll move on to the mod 8 up counter.